The word Kathakali opens up a magical world of imagination, a world that is peopled by gods and demons, by good people and evil people, where there are horrendous conflicts between these two opposing forces, and eventually where good is victorious over evil. Kathakali, the magnificent story dance of Kerala, the southern state of India, takes you on a flight of imagination. Katha means story, and Kali is a performance. It's a story dance where the episodes from the two great Indian epics, Mahabharata and Ramayana, are depicted. The greatest characteristic of Kathakali is its magnificent costuming, which is in Sanskrit called Aharya Abhinaya. There are magnificent huge headgears which are called kiritams. And there are billowing skirts from waist down which support and balance these great headgears. The kiritams have different designs and different sizes according to the type of the character. The characters are divided into three broad-based categories. The first is the sattvika characters, the good beings, in which you can include gods and righteous kings like Lord Rama or King Nala. The second type of character is the katti vesham, and in this there is a green base applied to the cheeks, but there is an outline like a knife made in red, which denotes that this particular character, though a good one, has a vicious streak in it. And thus these are kattiveshams, the rajasika type of characters, which are the middling characters. And then you have the tamasika type of characters, which are absolutely low characters. These are called the tadi vesham, tadi meaning the beard. And there are different colors in these beards. One is the red beard, where you have the absolutely outrageous characters, evil ones, like Dushasana or Bakasura. The second ones are the white beards, the Vellathadi. Now, these are lowly characters, but by the purity of their souls and characters, they come up. To this category belongs the monkey god, Hanuman. And then you have the black beards, which are the absolute low beings, forest dwellers and hunters. There is one more category of characters, which are Minakka characters or the shiny ones. In this category belong the various rishis, sages, Brahmins and high-born women. In the women characters, the stri veshams, you have the demonesses with horrendous black makeup and protruding breasts, and these are called the kari characters. But you also have a category when this demoness assumes the form of a beautiful woman, Lalita, and she goes out to entice people. These are the broad-based characteristics of Kathakali makeup. The makeup is done in the makeup room where the actor dancer lies down on the ground. The paste, the color paste, the base, is made by grinding natural powders with coconut oil. And there is a very beautiful phenomenon where the outline of the chin is made with a white patti, which is called chutti. This is made up of a paste of rice flour and chalk, and it is held together by strips of cloth. When the demons come, they bear huge fangs, which are hidden in the mouth, but which are taken out at relevant points. The musical system of Kathakali is the indigenous one of Kerala, Sopana Sangeetam. The orchestra is thunderous, as befitting a magnificent dance style where two tremendous forces come in conflict. There is a cylindrical drum which is called chanda, which is played by two sticks. There is a maddalam, which is a very old percussion instrument which is played on the sides. Sometimes there is an hourglass shaped drum cum drone which is called erikia, which is played with one stick. There are huge discs, cymbals, yelathalam, and there is one huge copper disc which is on which the rhythm is kept by the lead singer. This completes the Kathakali orchestra. Now we come to a very famous Kathakali presentation, Attakatha, called Kalyana Saugandhikam. Every Kathakali artist would like to perform in it. It represents a very famous story from the epic Mahabharata. The five Pandavas, the five brothers, had been banished to the forest. They have taken their wife, Queen Draupadi, with them. The second one of the Pandava brothers, Bhimasen, and Draupadi are walking around in the forest. And there, at their feet, falls a fantastic flower, full of beauty, but its fragrance has never been experienced anywhere. Draupadi is enchanted with the flower and requests Bhimasen to get some more flowers for her so that she could make a beautiful garland out of those flowers. Ever ready to please his queen, Bhimasen, who really pities her plight where she is banished to the forest with them, rushes forth to get the flower. In that forest lives the great monkey god Hanuman. Hanuman is supposed to be Pavanaputra, the son of breeze, Vayu. So is Bhimasen. Thus Hanuman becomes Bhimasen's elder brother. Hanuman is deep in tapas, where his tapas is completely shattered. He is first angry, and then he looks forth and he says, "What is this? Is it a tornado coming towards me? Who is this?" Then he perceives a man of great strength, progressing valiantly, proudly through the forest. Then he realizes that it is his younger brother, Bhimasen. Hanuman, the great devotee of Lord Rama, divines the reason for Bhimasena's approach, and he decides to tease Bhimasen. He says, "This little brother of mine, full of love for his wife, all right, I am going to tease him." Thus, with his prayers to Lord Rama, he turns into an old monkey, very old monkey, decrepit, who cannot walk, who cannot stand, and he stumbles across the path from which Bhimasena is progressing. Bhimasena looks at the monkey and said, "Hey, you old monkey, get out of my way. I cannot do so, sire. Please cross over me. It is prohibited in our shastras not to cross anybody. And then my elder brother, Hanuman, is also a monkey. Will you get off?" Hanuman says, "Sire, I cannot do so. I'm so weak. I'm so ill. I'm so old. Why don't you lift me up by my tail and throw me off?" Bhimasena starts laughing and in sheer contempt tries to lift up the tail. He cannot budge it even an inch, and that is when he realizes this is a very great entity. Thus Hanuman reveals himself in his true form, embraces his younger brother, he calls him the little brother, and sends him on his way. Enacting the role of Hanumana is Kalamandalam Ramankutty Nair, the greatest actor today for enactment of Hanumana roles. Let us now have a look at this gorgeous presentation of Kalyana Saugandhikam. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. കടന്നു പോവതിനിപ്പോൾ
കാലം കളയാതെ ഗമിച്ചാലും
കവി വരാ വഴിയുന്നു.